guys, welcome back to the channel. Here I am again on board of the Forza 350. It's very similar to the last motorcycle that I did a test drive, which is the Forza 125, but there are some things that are different on this motorcycle. First of all, if you pay close attention to the 125, you don't have the kill switch here. Here you have the idling stop button, which this motorcycle does not have. So this is one of the difference. The other difference, it's on the storage underneath the seat, where you have a little bit of carpet in order to protect your stuff and protect all the plastics. And the 125, it's all plastic, so this gives it a little bit more premium. And also on the 125, you have a little small extra space where the battery is, where you can store small things, which this one does not have. Everything else, from what I can see, it's exactly the same. I didn't find any other difference on the look of the motorcycle between the two models. Dashboard is the same, the commuters are all the same except that button, of course, which I already told you. And the main thing, of course, that's gonna change, it's the engine, which is, this one is almost double the horsepower of the 125. Another thing I forgot to mention that I found out while I was test riding the 125 is that you can disconnect and connect the traction control while riding, simply by pressing the T button here. And you can see traction control is off, and if I press again, traction control is on. So this is something that I found on the 125. You know my videos, they are always like this. I don't have scripts, I don't have those things. I just sit my ass on the motorcycle and I'm talk the things as I see them, and basically see it. And sometimes I have to do these second videos because I forgot little details. So another thing, on this uphill here, the other one was going around 100 kilometers an hour. With the 350, I can go much faster than that. 120 and still developing. 125, 130. This is what the 350 gives you over the 125. They both have excellent wind protection, bigger windscreens, fairings are big enough to protect your legs, but it's the engine. Having this engine, it makes everything much more pleasurable. Okay, I love scooters. I do own a SIM GTS 125, but I'm at that point that I'm getting bored with the top speed limitation of the 125s. That 100 to 110 kilometers an hour, sometimes it's very boring. And I do this commute, which we are doing now every day, home to work, and sometimes I feel the need that I want to go just like this, a little bit faster. You see, the road is clear, and with this one I can. If I was on my 125, I was limited to go at speeds like this, something around this, okay? No, a little bit more, okay? Not that, but okay, something like this, and I was limited to these speeds. So I'm thinking I have to change my 125 in the future, because the 300, it's the way I want to go. And of course a scooter, okay? I do love scooters, especially these ones with big storage underneath the seat. Of course I would put a top case on the motorcycle, because I do love the top cases. It's much practical for me with the top case. And a little bit more power, 130, and go gadget. Woohoo! 140, blinkers. I can reach 140. Yes, I can. Please, let's go. 140, and I still have power. Okay, still going. 150. Okay, let me stop now. Enough of having fun. So this is what this scooter has to offer. Having said this, guys, it's raining. As you can see, look, the windscreen is all wet. I really need to close this because I don't have my my rain gear. So luckily I'm almost home. Please don't forget, subscribe to the channel, click the notification bell below so you receive my future videos, and I really hope I can see you in the next one. Bye!